Thanks for joining us. Today, I'm here to talk to you about vaccine misinformation. What's vaccine misinformation, you ask? Well, do you remember what your Aunt Linda said on the family Zoom call on Thanksgiving?
Well, I read on the internet that the vaccines contain microchips that are injected into your body so the government can track you.
That's vaccine misinformation. They are myths that are spread around, usually online, about vaccines. And there are lots of them. So we brought in some experts to present the truth around some of the myths we've all heard. Let's have a look.
Well, I read the vaccines were rushed, so that makes them dangerous.
The process of the speed did not compromise at all safety. It was a reflection of the extraordinary scientific advances in these types of vaccines, which allowed us to do things in months that actually took years before.
Well, I heard the vaccine can make you sick and even give you the COVID.
This is a myth. All the components that go into vaccines are heavily tested to be sure that everything that is in there is safe for humans.
Dude, we already had coronavirus, so we don't need the vaccine.
Boo!
In general, we are now recommending that people should get a vaccine regardless of the fact whether they've had a previous infection or not. Even if you've had a previous infection and you now get a vaccine, it acts like a booster and it boosts that immune response.
Thanks, doctors. But it seems no matter how hard we try, people are going to spread myths about the virus and the vaccines. So what can you do? Here's some advice from Canada's Chief Public Health Officer, Dr. Teresa Tam.
When you look at a piece of information, ask a number of questions, including exactly where does this come from? Is that domain name credible? Definitely ask yourself this question before you forward the information to someone else. So be media smart as well as science smart, if you like.
Thanks, Dr. Tam. But what about those microchips Aunt Linda mentioned?
There are no microchips in the vaccine.
Well, there you go, Aunt Linda. So remember, be media smart and science smart. Thanks for watching.